It's Daryl Makk with the Planet Tour, and we're coming to you from the Calgary Motorcycle Show. On this episode, we're going to be checking out all the great new rides and gear at the Calgary Motorcycle Show. I'm going to take you back to the Kootenay Mountains in British Columbia, and coming up soon, viewer mail. The Calgary Motorcycle Show had so much to see. Great new models from so many different manufacturers, and it didn't matter if you were into big touring rigs, sport bikes, cruisers, trikes, dirt bikes, maybe something with a sidecar, and my favorite class of all, the sport touring motorcycle. There's also plenty of accessories, great new products, some things relating to life. Right next to the man van was the Ride for Dad booth. Now this is an organization that puts together many different rides right across Canada. We stopped in to say hi to them.
Tell us about the ride. What's it all about?
Well, the motorcycle ride is an annual event. It's called the Motorcycle Ride for Dad. It's a cross Canada ride which holds rides in approximately 29 cities across Canada, different days throughout the month of June. And it's to raise money for awareness and research towards prostate cancer.
Right, and you guys have hooked up with a man van here, which just took some blood out of me a little while ago to check for the PSA test, the prostate check.
Yeah, absolutely, and it's a good time. You know, anybody around that age of 40 and up should start getting checked as early as their 30s. We were finding that prostate cancer is becoming a prevalent disease. It's the number one cancer in Canada right now. A lot of people don't realize that. We have partnered with the Prostate Cancer Center here in Calgary, where we've helped them provide funds for some of their research and awareness. And we've also provided funds through the Motorcycle Ride for Dad to do research in the Calgary area. So when we raise funds here, the money stays here as well. So that's a really good thing.
And I'll be at the ride this year. Get your prostate check, folks, and support the Ride for Dad if you're in any of the cities across Canada. You can look it up. What's the website?
www.motorcycleridefordad.org.
.org, you got that.
After that, it was a dash across the bike show floor to get to the Q107 booth and talk to Zen and West.
It's 12:31. Good afternoon. I'm Zen and West. Q107 is at the 2011 Calgary Motorcycle Show at the BMO Center. And comedian Daryl Makk is doing some shows here as well. How you doing, Daryl?
I'm doing great, Zen. Thanks for having me on the show.
Hey, my pleasure. My pleasure. So you're doing this Planet Tour.
Yeah, the Planet Tour is a web series. I videotape my adventure. I live on my motorcycle all summer long and ride from one show to the next and just videotape it so the audience can follow along. I did cross country this year, right?
Yeah.
Coast to coast. Racked up 22,000 clicks in about 3.5 months.
Wow. And so you do comedy shows on the road as well?
I do comedy shows on the road. I try and bring riders and non-riders together so people can understand that bikers aren't bad people like the idiots in Hollywood want to paint us. Actually, it's my first motorcycle show with the Planet Tour.
Okay,
because
cool.
The project's only a year old, and we're trying to get awareness to get people to subscribe. You go to theplanettour.com.
We signed up for the Planet Tour, and we got free tickets.
Okay, looking forward to seeing the show, and all the details at planettour.com.
Theplanettour.com. Subscribe to the show. You might win some prizes.
Excellent. Daryl Makk, thanks a bunch for chatting with us.
Hey, thanks for having me down.
It's Dire Straits on Calgary's only classic rock, Q107.
I'm Heather Ireland from Biker TV, and you're watching the Planet Tour.
There's also an amazing stunt show put on by the FMX Freestyle team, including stunts on ATVs. Check out some of the stuff these guys do. Wow. They're good. I'll stick to long distance riding myself.
I'm Jerry from Blue Circle Insurance, and we support the Planet Tour.
As well, I met up with a few celebrities in the motorcycle world.
Hello.
And I've watched your show many times. Tell the people who may not be familiar with your show, tell us a little bit about it.
Well, we're Canadian motorcycling from A to Z. We're a weekly show. We just launched our 7th season. We're on A Channel Access. It would be Access Alberta, since we're in Calgary. And yeah.
And the website?
The website is bikertv.ca.
Bikertv.ca. Check it out, folks.
Jeremy Craker, who wrote Motorcycle Therapy, and Patty Tyson, who writes for Mojo Motorcycle Magazine.
This is Patty Tyson, folks. He writes an article called Flight of the Pegasus in Motorcycle Mojo. Say hi to the folks there, Patty.
Hi, folks there.
Tell them about your book. Show them your book here. Got this book.
My book has a funny name, The Hunt for Puerto del Faglioli. I couldn't possibly tell you what it means. You're going to have to read chapter 2. It's a motorcycle adventure in search of the improbable, starting in Halifax, which is improbable in itself, across Canada, around the US, all the way down to the impenetrable Darien Gap, Colombia. That's it.
until you have enough, you have to read it.
Well, that's right. And I'm going to put a link up on my website to his book. And you know what? I get to get a copy in exchange for my new USB drive that has my comedy album. So
free copy.
Free copy, free USB. Let's do the exchange right here on camera.
Cool.
All right. Thank and you just subscribed to the Planet Tour, didn't you?
Yes.
Tell absolutely. The people out there to do the same.
Do the same. Subscribe to the Planet Tour. Follow his every move. Laugh.
And follow his move. You can get him in Motorcycle Mojo.
Now, after the break, I'll tell you about my trip out to the Toad Rock Motorcycle Rally.
I'm Jordan Zoke.
I'm Amy Zoke.
And you're watching the Planet Tour.
The Toad Rock is a motorcycle campground in the beautiful Kootenay Mountains near Belfort, British Columbia. The rally has attracted thousands of riders from all over since 2003. I'd heard so much about it and had to check it out. All makes of motorcycles are welcome, although it's predominantly filled with the V-twin cruiser types. Now, can a sport bike enthusiast have fun at a biker rally filled with cruisers? Let's find out. I took James Moore from Comedy Monday Night with me. Now, James is a diehard sport bike enthusiast. Here he is next to his RZ 500, which is one of the bikes him and I have done trips with. He was a bit reluctant to travel to a rally filled mostly with cruisers and noisy V-twins.
James, what do you say? Let's go to the Toad Rock Bike Rally, July long weekend.
Toad Rock Rally. I don't know, man. That's really not my kind of thing. There'd be a lot of fat cruisers out there.
Finally convinced he would not have to ride in a large group or do a poker run, he was convinced to come out to the rally.
There'd be some sport bikes too. Let's represent the sport touring bikes.
It's fun. There could be people partying. They got music, all kinds of stuff set up there.
Okay. But I'm not going on a poker run.
No poker runs, no group rides. We'll do our own thing. There's great roads. We'll just do our own thing and have fun.
Toad Rock.
Cheers.
We decided to run through Radium and down to Highway 3 as a more scenic way of getting to the rally. We stopped in Canmore, Alberta for breakfast and met up with a good friend, Jeremy Craker. The weather changed on us from sunny and sort of warm to cool and at times wet. We had to stop to add layers and put on our electric heated clothing at one point as the increase in elevation was sapping our bodies of heat. We were down into the single digits on the Celsius scale. Now, if you're going to tour in Canada, electric clothing is something I highly recommend be in your gear. Not only for comfort, but for safety too. Cold body creates slow reaction times. Near Radium, James went off to chase some corners just before the town. So intent was he on getting some leaning time in, he totally missed a grizzly bear right on the side of the highway. I had to stop as grizzly bears are a little bit elusive and hard to spot in the wilderness. We made it as far as Creston, BC and popped in to say hi to a riding buddy, Howard. Oh, he dressed up for the occasion. Nice rubber boots, Howard. Now, Howard's the guy I bought Susie B from. He was happy to see us. He's an awesome fellow. A few beers later, we knew our trip was done for the day.
Look, I just sold him the bike. I didn't know the bike was going to create the show and let him be the co-star. I mean, what's with that, eh?
The next morning, we awoke to rain. So we waited for the weather to change so we could do the awesome drive from Creston, BC up to Crawford Bay and the ferry landing on the famed 3A. 3A is one of the best highways in Canada for riding, and we didn't want to do it in the wet, that's for sure. There's a ferry ride going across Kootenay Lake, which is nice, scenic, and relaxing. Here's your chance to eat, check your gear, or hang out with many of the riders already out there enjoying the area. As you pull into Belfort, check out the Osprey Nest as you enter the docking area. We can see the Dock and Duck Pub there. Great place to fill your belly with some awesome food, and they've also got a bed and breakfast. 5 minutes off the ferry, we hit Toad Rock. Now, arriving a day late meant campsites were few and far between as people had filled every space with bikes and tents. Eventually, we found a campsite that was suitable.
So this is camp. This is going to be home for a couple of days, right in the shade when it gets dark.
There are all kinds of bikes and vehicles, including the campground workhorse that has been dubbed the Volvolac. Some of the early arrivals had scooped up the few cabins and trailers, while others just improvised, like this tarp city that was home for about 12 weary bikers. With all the crowds, a few tried to blend in, like this guy with his camouflage tent, which hit him beautifully, except for the bright orange tent beside him. There's music and campfires, great people, food, and of course, some girl to talk me into something strange, like trying out a sex swing. I kept my clothes on, you're welcome. But it was fun as Robin showed me how it worked. James was having a good time. Well, once he found some other riders that were into sport bikes like him, Well, there's another full day of activity at the rally, but we had other places to be, so we said our goodbyes and headed back across the lake to Kokanee Chalets and Resort. The owner, Paul, who's also a writer and a budding stand-up comic, invited us to stay for the night. And after a wet night in a tent, a little bit of luxury was just what we needed before we started our trip back to Calgary. The weather was on and off rain. We made a brief stop at Ryder's Ranch so I could book my site for my KGB trip in a few weeks. Ryder's Ranch is another awesome stop if you're on a motorcycle. No big RVs and families to contend with there.
James and I had a really good time at the Toad Rock Rally, despite the weather being a little wetter than we wanted. But hey, rain or shine, it's always a fun time. Limited spaces, so if you want to go, check it out. The website's right there on the screen. And after the break, we're going to have viewer mail.
Hi, I'm Jen.
And I'm Steph.
And you're watching the Planet Tour.
Hey, folks, now it's time for some viewer mail. Viewer mail this week is brought to you by
Universal Cycle, the official mechanical shop of the Planet Tour and Canadian distributor of Dragon Jeans.
From Claude in Burnaby, BC. Hey, Daryl, nice to see you up and healing okay. Looking forward to watching your videos next season. I'm a bit biased, but have you looked at a used Kawasaki Concours 1400 as a replacement for Susie? Going from Susie to Connie, he said it wouldn't be a bad transition. She is considered one, if not the best sports tour out there. Good luck in the search. Well, Claude, I had looked at a couple of Concours 1400s. I actually did own the 1000 Concours. That was the one that was killed, murdered by that hit and run driver in 2008. Great machine. The 1400, though, for the newer ones, just a little out of my price range, unless someone knows of a screaming deal on one. Like I said, I only had so much insurance money. But thank you for your email. We've got another one here. Stacy from Slave Lake, Alberta. How's that thing in your pants that is bulgy and full of fluid? That made me laugh when you said it in your video, but then again, I'm not very mature. No, you're not, Stacy, and that is my kind of viewer. There's another one here, Rene in Montreal. Like, dude, it's Rene, the reckless one, Wall of Death. Bike-wise, I'd recommend the Harley Sportster 1200, around $1,000 to $4,000, but really good one for about $3,000 to $4,000. Believe me, you will see the difference in all aspects. Glad to hear you're still traveling, all is good. Signed, Renee. You know, I appreciate that. The Sportster, I don't really think it's my kind of bike. First off, it doesn't have any windshield or fairing protection, and I had enough cold weather last year. And the only windshields you can put on a Sportster are those handlebar mounted ones, which I'm not a big fan of, because if they catch a crosswind, you can have handling problems. It also has an extremely small tank, and there's nothing worse than having to get off the bike every hour and a half instead of every 2.5 to 3 hours, especially when you're doing stops, do videotaping. And the other thing is, some of you guys out there with your V-twin pride, you better sit down. I don't like the sound of a Harley engine. That thumpa-thumpa of a V-twin air-cooled pushrod engine just doesn't stir my soul. I'm sorry, it doesn't. I know a lot of you guys love your Harleys. There's nothing to me like the scream of an inline four. It just the smooth, quick power delivery that I don't think there's a Harley out there that can match it. I'm not a cruiser guy. I love sport tours. I am looking at some of those adventure tours as well. I like to do some off-road touring. But thanks, Rene, but I just know that the Sportster is not going to be for me.
So keep those emails coming, folks, and if you have any duck ass stories, I want to hear about them, especially if you have video. Right now, I'm sitting on the new 1250 GSF from Suzuki. This is the model that replaces the Bandit, which is what Susie B was. It's an awesome bike. A little too close to Susie for me, though. I'm still searching for my new ride. Come up in the next episode. We'll be talking more about Susie's replacement. For the Planet Tour, I'm Daryl Makk.
We're promoting Dragon Jeans, and which is an excellent
product. Are you wearing yours right now?
I'm not wearing them right now. I'm having a bit of a muffin top issue.
A muffin top issue.
Rocking the muffin top at the Calgary Motorcycle Show.
I'm not even sure I know what that means.
All right, bikes are parked. We're in the Kootenays. Woo-hoo. Cheers. Pretty nice part of the planet. Check it out.